No way. Not about to contribute to your shady venture. You'll tell me what you know for free.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. As you wish, sir. I know the fellow you seek, though I don't know his name. A steady patron gets his boots cleaned every few days. He's very good to me. Always pays me a premium.
Know where I might find him?
No. But you could wait here. Perhaps he'll stop by.
Don't have the time for that. Sure you don't know where to find him? Or maybe notice which direction he came from?
When I clean boots, sir, I do not look up to see where folk come from. I clean.
It seems you're having a rough go of it.
Oh, you're here. Feeling better?
I am, thank you. The local necropolis. The air does wonders for me. Now, if I might intercede, I dare say I've the right question to ask. Young man, you see this vial? One drop added to your boot polish will help you wipe even the most encrusted boot clean as the dome of St. Lebioda's Cathedral. With it, you will serve three times as many patrons at a fraction of the effort, and piles more coin. I'm prepared to give you this vial if you tell me where the man we seek lives.
But you won't hurt him, will you? The gentleman's art, true, but he's kind.
In point of fact, he's a friend. Yet we had a falling out of sorts and would like to straighten matters out.
I leave his boots at the door of a house near the port. The door is red, but I do not know if the gentleman lives there.
Worth checking. Might happen on a lead.
Would you let me scrape the dirt off your kickers before you go? With all due respect, sirs, your boots could stand a cleaning.
Thank you. Perhaps later.
Handled that kid pretty well.
Finding the right approach. That's the trick to dealing with children.
Yeah, saw that. Meaning, the right thing to bribe them with.
Good folk, have you seen these prices?
Red door, one the bootblack mentioned. Gotta break it down.
You might just as well stand out in the street, pound on a drum and holler, Detlaf, I'm coming for you. A bit more finesse, I implore you.
Let's hear your idea.
Give me a moment.
Nice. Ever consider becoming a burglar? Skill like that would come in awful handy.
I considered it briefly, but ultimately concluded it would be terribly dull. Come. Was here recently. His scent is still strong.
Let's look around. Old toy. No use to anyone. Shame. Must have brought someone joy sometime. Attic. Let's go. So this is his nest. Need to look around. Woman's likeness. Bit smudged. Is his lover?
I don't rightly know.
Reminds me of someone.
Who?
Not sure. Can't help feeling I've seen that face before, though. nice tune.
Indeed. I'm not certain why, but it reminds me of home. Our true home from before the conjunction of spheres.
Tools were used recently. Detlaff unwind by fixing toys between murders.
Really now, Geralt, must you?
Look, slips of paper, name on each. Count Crespi, Count Dulac, Milton de Peyrac Peyrin, Count Delacroix.
Detlaff's victims, one and all. But that's not his hand.
All of it written using the same ink. See the color? Ink was dyed with cinnabarite. Rare mineral, pretty much found only in...
Nazaire. But I fear it means very little. Anyone could have imported such ink.
Fair enough. Still worth remembering.
Look, this slip is stained.
With wine. Not much to go on either. Especially not in Beauclair.
Perhaps. Yet perhaps also worth remembering.
Still got nothing, basically. Need to look around some more.
Let's get to work.
Somebody fixed this recently. No dust mark. Somebody moved this here recently. Nice little trinket. Sometimes I think I might end up like one of these toys. Somebody fixed this recently. No dust mark. Somebody moved this here recently. Nice little trinket. Sometimes I think I might end up like one of these toys.
I find these puppets rather disturbing.
Somebody fixed this recently. No dust mark. Somebody moved this here recently. Nice little trinket. Tools were used recently. Detlaff unwind by fixing toys between murders.
Really now, Geralt, must you?
Detlaff van der Eretain, you do not know us, but we know you to be a vampire. We know also of your weakness for the wench they call Renewed. Now you know this. We shall chain her down and let rats feed on her. We shall flay the skin from her flesh. Yet you can save her. You need but travel to Beauclair, where you shall slay 5 men in the manner we prescribe. You must complete the killing in 3 days. Fail, and the next letter you receive will contain a memento of your failure. Your beloved's finger.
There you have it. Proof positive Detlaff killed not of his own accord.
A blackmailer sunk his claws into him.
idea what it could be? Detlaf have any enemies?
Indeed. Detlaf gains foes occasionally, but they never live long.
One might have managed to evade him.
Possible in theory, but I know of none. It would have to be someone devilishly dangerous. As you well know, having faced Detlaf yourself.
Whoever it is someone new.
Who's Renawed?
His one-time lover. The sole human woman with whom he was very close. Because she accepted him. With her aid and care, he found a place for himself in this hostile world. She began the work that I strive to continue.
Ever meet her?
Never had the pleasure, alas. She deserted him a time before he came around to save me, though he always claimed she'd gone missing.
Why do you think that? Any signs or clues to that effect?
None to be found. Apparently she disappeared one day. Her belongings disappeared with her. Not a scenario one associates with kidnapping.
In my humble opinion, she left on her own. Scared off, perhaps, by a bout of Detlaf's rage that revealed his other, more monstrous side.
Detlaf have trouble letting go, accepting that she'd left him?
Is that so hard to believe? Do you know no humans who've struggled with just such a thing?
And Detlaf is so much more emotional than most humans.
Not only was she his beloved, his lover, his mate, she was a member of his pack. And one never leaves one's pack voluntarily.
Detlaf ever try to find her? I mean, if she was that important. Higher vampires have their ways, all kinds. Should have been easy as pie for him.
Geralt, as you rightly noted, we are vampires, not miracle workers. He searched for months on end before giving up. Clearly Renawed knew him all too well. Enough to cover her tracks, leave no way for him to find her.
Even if Renawed did abandon him that time, looks like someone's actually kidnapped her this time.
Hard to argue with that. And hard to foresee what he's prepared to do to free her, get her back.
He's prepared to kill, that's clear.
As would you be for Yennefer. He kills, for he cares for her deeply. And that blood, those individuals, they mean nothing to him.
Yeah, I get it now. He's out to rescue a female from his pack.
Exactly.
Blackmailer. Kinda curious who it could be.
Why is that?
Regis. Somebody kidnapped a vampire's lover. Bold to begin with. Now they're forcing the vampire to kill. A vampire you yourself insisted no murderer. Blackmailer's skilled. Someone special.
Astute. Now that I think of it, I'm beginning to wonder if...
It's not one of your kind? Another vampire?
Precisely. The plot thickens.
Just a hypothesis. Wouldn't set my heart on it till we know more.
Right you are.
Let's sum up what we know. Seems Detlaf's being blackmailed. Someone's been feeding him his victims' names.
All noted down using one and the same Nazeri ink, and not in his handwriting.
Not much.
But enough to ascertain Detlaf's innocence, clearly.
Actually, it is. Detlaf's being manipulated. Some lunatics turned him into a tool, making him kill.
So it would seem. But this illuminates a path of action for us. We must find Renawed. Render the blackmail senseless. The lunatic or ticks will thus lose hold on Detlaf.
That's one idea. Could be worth a shot. But what about Detlaf? He gonna go on killing while I'm out searching for his lover?
He will not. I shall convince him to stay his hand. Assure him you're a friend seeking to help. I'll await him here. He's sure to return sooner or later.
Think he'll listen?
He will.
Oughta wait with you, maybe.
No. He'll sense you from a mile off, simply fail to appear. I'd better stay alone. You must trust me on this.
Fine. Need to report to the Duchess first.
So be it. We'll await you here. Detlaf and I both.
Send a whip await those running riot. values peace and quiet.
Oop, yep, I'm going to heave.
You can't pull one over on me, Witcher. I can see.
I have doubled there.
These knights of ours should turn
their attention to... Geralt of Rivia, Master Witcher.
I was not mistaken. You arrived and trouble followed soon after.
Step aside. Got a matter for the Duchess.
At last, Witcher. We've been on tenterhooks. Did you catch Milton's killer?
The case is more serious than we thought. The beast? I couldn't kill it. Didn't manage.
We sent you after a monster, and you return with nothing? We are very disappointed.
Situation's not quite that simple. Beast's a powerful vampire.
Ha! Is this a problem? Is it too much for a witcher? A monster slayer? But everyone knows how to end a vampire. Draw him by trick into sunlight. Or arm yourself with ample garlic and drive a stake through its heart.
Garlic's useless against vampires. Sun and stakes don't hurt him either. Those methods, pure invention. Only work in legends and fables.
And buckthorn? When I was a child, Grandmama Admarta always claimed buckthorn drives off vampires.
Silver sword's your best option for keeping them at bay. But it won't get the job done, because only a higher vampire can truly kill another of its kind.
Excuses. Ha! Your Grace, I shall assemble a battue. Bring the matter to its end at once. The Witcher need but tell us where to find this monster.
Whoa, this is work for a Witcher, not for your guardsmen.
Yet when a Witcher fails, my guardsmen must step in. I'll take my best. 40 hardened veterans. No vampire can stand up to that.
40, 50, 100? Doesn't matter. Won't make any difference against him.
You have not seen my guardsmen in action.
Can they fight fog? Hit a target that moves faster than the wind?
How? What creature can do such things?
Creatures like this one. Higher vampires, we call them. Each one's a little different. Unique or exceptional, you might say. Some transform into giant bats. Others communicate with animals, command them.
Yet all are still brainless beasts.
Dead wrong. Thinking of lesser vampires. Alps, Ekamaras, Catacans, for instance. They're ruled by instinct, sure. Attack anything that smells of blood. Higher vampires? They think. They employ reason.
Monsters driven by reason. A curious contention. What, then, do you intend to do?
It's way beyond being some monster. This is a powerful being that's walked the world for centuries.
Yeah, impossible. If so great is their power, why have they not killed or enslaved us all?
Don't usually meddle in our matters. Mostly stay out of our way because they don't care about humans one way or the other.
And they do not fear we shall wipe them out one day.
They'd probably be pretty amused if you asked them that. They're well aware of their strength.
Then what can we do? Do you have a plan?
Try to talk to him. That's our best bet.
I cannot believe this. Her Grace summons a Witcher to kill a monster. Instead, he wishes to chat with it.
Know what I'm doing. His lover was kidnapped. He's being blackmailed.
Blackmailed? Be so kind as to explain how a vampire might be blackmailed.
Higher vampires? They're like us, motivated by emotions, not instinct. Not only are they intelligent to an extreme, they're emotionally rich, capable of feeling many things, even love. This one fell in love with a woman, a human, and he'll do anything to keep her from harm.
You do not, I trust, suggest we let Milton's killer go free, or wait until it murders again. We must render it harmless as quickly as possible.
Which is why that's my aim now, to prevent further attacks. Vampire's only half the problem. Blackmailer's at fault chiefly. Kidnap the woman to control the vampire.
And what do you propose to do?
I'll find the blackmailer, free the vampire's lover.
You were to destroy him, not help him.
No one else should die. That's most important. As soon as the woman's safe, he'll have no more reason to kill.
I admit to being swayed, Witcher. You may be right. Do you know anything about the blackmailer?
Got one lead. A few scraps of paper. Blackmailer wrote the names of the vampire's victims on them. One of them stained. A drop of wine, looks like. So damn little to go on.
You've no idea how wrong you are, my dear. Send for the Ducal Sommelier. Hop, hop! In Tucson, wine is sacred. Here there is no such thing as a drop of wine, or stains therefrom. They are stains from a drop of Estest, Ervelus, Fiorano.
Your Grace wished to see me?
Witcher, show him the paper scrap. Benoit, can you determine which wine made this stain?
Yes. The west bank of the Saint Retour. That's rather obvious. Aged in barrels of Beauclair oak. Hue, deep burgundy. Clarity, high. It's simple. Saint Real. The 1269 vintage.
That's impossible. The wine is produced at Castel Ravello, especially and exclusively for the ducal table. Perhaps some Sonreal was stolen. We must go to the vineyard, see if there's not been an incident.
Sonreal? Never heard of it.
It's highly unlikely you've ever had a chance to partake of it. As I said, it is only ever served to the ducal family.
Didn't stop it from ending up on that scrap of paper. Unless Your Grace's sommelier is mistaken.
In matters of wine, Benoit is never mistaken. If he says it's Sonreal, it is Sonreal. We must ride to Castel Ravello at once. Discover what has happened.
Wait. Your Grace wants to go with me? Out of the question.
I hope you do not suppose we will sit on our ducal hiney and do nothing while our duchy is in grave danger.
Your Grace, what you propose is far too dangerous. The Witcher should go alone.
It pleases me to see you gentlemen finally agree on something. But I've made my decision. We shall go, accompanied by the best possible escorts. You, Captain, and Geralt. We will travel incognito. We've no wish to give the court any reason to gossip. For the duration of this mission, I release you from your obligation to adhere to court protocol. In short, from now on, I am Anna Henrietta, not Your Grace.
Yes, Your Grace. Witcher, are you ready?
Yeah, ready to go.
Excellent. Give me a moment. I must don something more appropriate and concealing. Then we will be off.
This vampire, have you ever faced its sort before?
I have.
How did it end? Did you kill it?
Didn't have to fight him. Hadn't killed anyone.
Have you ever heard of anyone defeating such a vampire?
Know of a man who defeated one, sure. But he didn't manage to kill it. Ultimately, only another vampire can kill a vampire. Take it easy.
Panthers have attacked the wagon!
Slow.
We must help!
Stay back, Your Grace! We shall see to this!
Let's go!
Thank you, beast!
Done. Time to move on.
If not for you, we'd have been done for.
They were fortunate.
Thank
we
you.
Happened by.
You saved our lives.
Hooray!
Tell me more about this vineyard, Castel Ravello.
It's the best in Ortusa. An old master of the winemaking trade runs it, Fabrizio.
He trustworthy?
He's held his post for years. There's never been a problem. Till now. I wish to know your thoughts, Geralt. The Sonrial stain, how did it wind up on the paper? Is someone from the vineyard blackmailing the vampire?
Could be a servant. Could be the steward. Could be the wine was just stolen from the estate.
We shall know when we arrive. It's not far now.
Slow now. Whoa.
Locked its writ and brought in chains.
Captain de la Tour, we did not expect any visitors from the palace. How are affairs at court?
Doubtless you've heard of the Beast of Beauclair. Well, we've our hands full. Especially since the rogue last attacked in the palace gardens.
I trust her illustrious highness was not harmed.
Kind of you to ask, Master Fabrizio. I am well.
Your grace? We were not warned. I shall order the salon prepared at once.
That won't be necessary. As you can see, we are not here on an official visit.
Naturally. Might I ask then what has brought you to Castel Ravello?
Came to see you. Got some questions.
In this land, it is seen as polite to introduce oneself before asking any questions.
This is Geralt of Rivia, a witcher. He has come to Toussaint on my personal invitation.
Which is to say...
Which is to say I expect you to treat him with the utmost respect.
Of course, Your Grace.
Did you hear that, Witcher? Fabrizio will be delighted to answer your every question.
Want to talk about Sonrial?
I am at your service.
The Sonrial. How many vineyard workers have access to it?
One might say only I do.
Not like you make the wine all alone. At least a dozen others work here.
I see you've little notion how wine is made. Grapes travel a long road before they become Sonrial. The workers assist me only to the stage of fermentation. I see to the maceration personally and let no one near the fat. Workers, again, assist me during barreling, but then I seal the aging barrels myself, each and every one. The wine lies in the cellar, gains character. Once this process is complete, it becomes Sonrial. And as it happens, only I have the key to the cellar in question.
Who hauls the barrels to the palace?
We've our own garrison. Guards who have served here for years and would answer with their heads for the wine.
We'll not get anywhere asking questions, I see. It's a waste of time.
Your Grace? How am I to understand this?
Master Fabricio, we have proof someone's gained access to San Real. Someone who should not have. Which means one of two things. Either you lie to our face, or you are an idiot who has had wine stolen from under his nose and not even realized it! In either case, you shall answer for it.
But...
Silence! And listen. I shall inspect the barrels in person, thus giving you time to reflect. When I return, I expect to hear answers. Remind me, where is the San Real stored?
In the main cellar, around the corner. I'll show you.
I shall find it. Give me the key to the cellar and wait here.
Oh, of course, Your Grace. Here it is.
Come, Witcher.
We shall wait here, Master Fabricio.
What if Fabricio's blackmailing the vampire? Considered that?
He has his flaws, but I would never suspect him of such a thing. He's been very loyal. He owes all he has to me. His father frittered away the family fortune. He left his son an encyclopedic knowledge of wine. That is all. Fabricio lived as a beggar until I appointed him steward of Castel Ravella. Only then did he come into his own.
So where do we start?
Let us see if all the barrels are present. Here's the inventory ledger.
Vintner's log. Fermentation completed with no complications. Tapped above sediment line. Here it is, barreling. Everything lines up at first glance. Neatly and thoroughly documented.
Then we must follow our other lead. Benoit said the stain came from the 1269 vintage. Let's find it.
Ervolus. I like it. Quite dry.
An excellent wine. You've good taste.
Est est. Think everyone and their mothers heard of this wine.
Among the best in the world. Castel Ravello is famous for it.
Got Pomino over here. San Real. Barrels are dated 1268.
Close, but not quite the right year.
Right here. 1269. What now?
Let's see if any barrels are empty.
Wanna open them?
For now, a knock will suffice. If you hear a hollow thud, we will have found what we seek.
Full.
Full.
This one's full too. Full. This one's full too. Looks like all the barrels are full. Dead end, I'm afraid.
Full they are. The question is, are they full of Sanreal? Grab a tap and a hammer. We shall open them one by one and taste.
Got the taps.
Then get to work. Let's broach those barrels.
Ready.
Step aside.
So?
Those hints of spice. Distinctive. This is Sanreal. Revolting. Bitter plonk!
Could have gone sour while aging.
Impossible! This is not wine. This is contaminated refuse that should never have made it into a barrel. The fact that it did was no accident, I'm sure.
Master Fabricio, let's see what he has to say about it.
Master Fabricio, I am very disappointed.
But your grace, I...
You are a step away from losing your head. Speak the truth and you might yet keep it.
I admit it. I sold a barrel of Sanreal. I beg you to forgive me.
Why did you do it?
I couldn't resist. The sum they offered, it was enormous. I gave in.
Is what I provide not enough?
I wished to buy back my family's estate. For here, nothing is truly mine. I've a roof over my head, ample food to eat, but what is a nobleman without land of his own? I shall tell you everything, if you agree to show me mercy.
Who'd you sell the wine to?
A few weeks past, at the pheasantry, a rich nobleman approached me. He called himself a diplomat, well-connected at court. He suggested we embark on an enterprise. Some of his clients had offered dizzying sums for even a drop of Sanreal. He was to serve as intermediary.
This man's name?
He never revealed it. He was tall, black-haired, and spoke with a foreign lilt. He claimed to hail from Sintra.
I've no Sintrian aristocrat at court.
Really thought nobody'd find out.
I was a fool, very foolish. I beg you, your grace, you must forgive me.
Wine itself, how'd you hand it over?
We met under the cover of darkness,
in the ruins of Fort Astre. A dozen or so men came to collect. Armed men. The kind that stink of trouble. I had hauled the barrel there. They transferred it to their cart, and we went our separate ways.
That's it? At the last you ever saw of them?
That is to say, a few days passed. A messenger arrived. He said they wished to buy another barrel and, well, I've prepared it. Have it ready to deliver.
That's enough. Know all we need to know.
Your Grace, I beg your forgiveness.
Get out of my sight. Captain, have your men take Master Fabrizio to the dungeon. He must answer for his crime. High treason, the charge. What now, Witcher?
We set a trap. Need to catch the wine thieves. Cintrian Noble could be our blackmailer. Next, transport. I'll take it to Fort Astra. Damien and his soldiers will cover me.
For once, I agree with you. We will do as you say. Let me know when you are ready.
Need a minute.
Make haste. We await only you. We would not... Without your grace. My men stand ready. Say the word and we will make for Fort Astra. It is time to catch these wine thieves.
See no reason to wait. Let's get going.
We will set out now. Position ourselves before you arrive. You take the cart and meet us there.
Fine. When the handoff begins, watch for my signal. Relax. Now we wait.
Ah, our favorite vintner.
Together! Together! Get on it, you rat scallion!
Is it just me, or did we agree you'd wait for my signal?
That was the plan, but...
Great shot. Good thing you reacted. Can't say how that would have ended otherwise.
At your service. It was a good fight. We managed to capture one of the scoundrels.
Let's ask him a few questions. Come on.
Witcher, a moment. I was wrong about you.
Well, had no reason to trust me, and I didn't do much to change that.
True. You are not the most endearing of men. At any rate, I see the effort you put forth. And I appreciate it. Let us go to Her Grace. She awaits nearby.
Wait, she here?
I hope you did not think I would leave this to you alone, especially when every hour could prove essential. This prisoner of yours, bring him to me. We must ask him some questions. Captain, do the honors.
Who sent you?
His name is Dog. They say he plowed your mother.
Once again, who sent you?
Your nun's lover. They call it...
Wait. He doesn't wish to speak. He needn't. I can think of several other ways he can be helpful. I'm certain the Witcher will need bait to lure the beast of Beauclair.
What?
Sure can. Fresh out.
In that case, he's all yours.
Captain, have your men find me a strong rope. Kind that won't snap when we hang this fellow from a tree.
Rope?
Live bait. Great for monsters, provided they catch the scent of its blood. But I'll see to that.
What? No. Crikey, no! Don't let him!
Stop screaming. Save your strength. Got a long night ahead of you.
No! Don't let him! I'll talk!
Barrels. Where were you gonna take them?
I don't know!
Captain, need that rope after all.
I truly don't know! Hornet's the leader, only he ever knew where to go. But he lies over there, dead. That one. The first barrel went to a warehouse at the port. But where this one was bound, I don't know! I speak true, you must believe me!
Who hired you?
He'll kill me!
Ought to be worried about me right now. Who is he?
Go on, man. Spit it out.
The Sintrian. That is what they call him. I've never seen him, but I know he mustered the men for his caper. That's what they said, that we were working for the Sintrian. I don't know anything else. I swear it.
Take him away. Throw him in the dungeon. He shall await trial there. Captain, we ride to town. Gather your men and seek out the Sintrian. Someone else must have seen him, must know of him.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll report to the palace as soon as I learn anything.
I shan't return to the palace. Our mission has not yet ended. The Witcher and I will await you at the guard post near the port.
Let's go to town.
He's late.
Relax, he'll come.
There's something I'd like to know. How can you be so damned calm?
Side effect of my mutations. We Witchers rarely get the jitters.
What if something has happened to him?
Captain seems like a man who can take care of himself.
Perhaps he can, but this Cintrian appears to be no common bandit. He managed to steal ducal wine from under my guardsman's gnosis. We only learned of it through a fortunate coincidence. And it was he who specified the victims for the vampire. One must be exceptionally confident to blackmail such a monster.
Still don't know this Cintrian's behind the kidnapping and blackmail. Might have just handled the theft of the wine.
Even if it's so, he then sold the wine to the blackmailers. As I see it, that makes him an accomplice.
Need to find the Cintrian, whether or not he's responsible for the murders. Even if none of it's his doing, he could still know our blackmailer's identity. Besides, it's one thing to know who ordered the killings. Other thing entirely, and just as important, is why they... Someone's coming.
Captain, why so long? We expected you hours ago.
This Cintrian does not work alone. We are fighting an organization, not one man. Bandits attacked us, not a small force either. One of my boys has a broken arm, another a shattered knee, lamed for life. And the word on the street is there's a hefty bounty on your head, Geralt.
Used to it. Not the first time I've been hunted.
Must you always? Now, the port warehouse where the wine was delivered, we identified it, then learned who had hired it out. This proved to be a beggar, a stand-in. We found him. He admitted all. A man had paid him to sign the lease, a man he met while begging outside the pheasantry. There, fate lent us a hand. A waitress recalled spilling wine on a nobleman who spoke with a Cintrian accent.
What did he look like?
Her description was not helpful. Handsome, well-dressed, with a beard. No distinguishing marks. This could be anyone. But she remembered his female companion very well, as she recognized her. On the Cintrian's arm was Cecilia Bellant.
The singer? I've heard of her. She's said to be gifted, fairy.
The same. We went to her home immediately. Cecilia was not there, but we questioned her servants. A chambermaid claimed Cecilia is to meet a Cintrian gentleman tonight. She'd invited him to a reception mounted by the Mandragora.
The Mandragora? What's that?
A club. An affiliation of local artists. Painters, sculptors, troubadours and dancers.
Never heard of it.
They exude mystique, consciously, I think. Behaving like an exclusive cabal. Artistic elites. Every now and again they mount soirees. Only wealthy patrons are invited. All arrive in elaborate masks, then drink and flirt.
Gotta nab the Cintrian. Seems we have to go to that get-together.
You read my mind, Witcher. I shall gather my men, surround the establishment. Not a mouse will squeeze through.
Out of the question. If the Cintrian truly does have men about the city, he will find out and escape once again.
Duchess is right. Need to be careful. Best go there, blend in with the crowd.
Precisely what we shall do.
We, Your Grace.
Geralt and I. In that sort of company, the Witcher could use my help.
Where's the event going to be held?
The Mandragora always assembles at the same place, a residence in Hauteville. It's a very distinguished district. Geralt, you must don appropriate attire. Then meet me in Hauteville, in Mountebank Alley.
Good luck. I hope you get the bastard. I should double the patrols, just in case. Or
audacious rat, the Cintrian. But we'll get him.
I wouldn't mind if that beast devoured me. I'd get some peace at last.
In the mood for fireworks and action.
Gideon!
Pull one over on me, Witcher. I can see you're a killer.
Long live Duquesa Anna Henrietta.
Welcome.
All jests aside.
Ever your servant, sir.
Around.
A Witcher.
Nice tune.
Duchess summoned him.
Heya!
Reginald Audrey has returned! No. Not to be missed! Buy your tickets now!